Now, billions of gallons gush out of the Rockies. For the goats, more at home in the high cliffs, rivers like this can be deadly. Nanny goats lead the way, showing the little ones how it's done. Nearly everyone is crossed, but he holds back. He follows an older cousin, but misses his mark and loses his nerve. Then, courage overcomes fear. That helped him cling to the cliffs are useless in the raging water. Times Square explosion of color and light, advertising that inside the forest, the sale is on. And everything must go. Gathering nuts for the winter while supplies last. His cheeks can stretch up to 3 times the size of his head. Nut collecting is serious business. By late fall, he will have amassed about 6,000 nuts, all stored in his multi-chambered underground burrow. He'll spend the winter in there, alternating between sleeping and eating. But shopper beware. Pickpockets are everywhere. This guy has got a better idea. Why drive yourself nuts running around the forest when your neighbor can do it for you? But he's spotted. Cheeks filled to bursting. Never mess with the chipmunk's nuts. Deep snow covers the Black Hills of the Dakotas, and hidden under that icy blanket, field mice are stirring. The odds of catching anything might seem hopeless, but not to him. An enormous leap to catch a critter under 3 feet of snow. But how the heck did he do it? He's homing in on something. But it takes immense concentration, and he needs complete quiet. his ears can pick up the faintest scamper from beneath the snow. But there's a catch. He almost always comes up empty-handed, unless he's facing north. But how's that possible? As unbelievable as it sounds, scientists now think he's actually homing in on the magnetic field of the planet, using it to calculate and plot his trajectory. The kind of math missiles use to hit their targets. Just the slightest distraction can throw him off. But if he's got the North Pole in his sights, he's guaranteed a meal nearly 75% of the time. If the snow were deeper, he could tunnel between bushes. But this winter's dusting leaves him exposed to his enemies. Worst of the bunch is the long-tailed weasel. He's no bigger than the rabbit and has bad eyesight, but his nose and ears are sharp, and his teeth are even sharper. A whiff of bunny, and it's game on. The weasel tries to follow his nose. But the rabbit's made a network of well-worn trails, always running in his own footsteps. The weasel can't figure out if he's coming or going. Game, set, and match. Bunny.